following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll-free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Let's go to our man Jim in Palm Harbor. Hey, what's going on, brother?
Hey, how you guys doing today?
Doing great, man. How you been?
Oh, great. I really appreciate you and Tommy. You do great job, great work, and I really appreciate it. I watch you every day.
Well, thank you so much. We appreciate you growling and prowling with us out here, man. Let's go to Sylvia in Tampa. Hey, Sylvia, how you doing?
Hey, Tom. Good morning. Thank you so much for taking my call. I want to tell you thank you so much for the advice you gave me on dust yesterday. I exited when you told me, and I made a healthy profit for
that's awesome.
For a very short period. So thank you.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Just we'll let you know I want to thank my team here. Everyone did an amazing job. We moved our headquarters from Clearwater, Florida, folks, to St. Petersburg, Florida. And we closed down on Friday and got back open today. It's a beautiful thing. You are what you believe you are. Humans are powerful magicians. You have the power to make yourself what you are right now, but it's not your reasoning mind that controls your power. It's what you believe. Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We have the Dow Industrials down 98. NASDAQ off 95, S&P's down 11, gold contract down $1.60, trading at $12.21 an ounce. Silver up 3 cents, $15.52 an ounce. Light sweet crude up $1.27, trading $69.96 a barrel. Notes and bonds, you get the 10-year note, down 2 ticks, 119.12. 30-year bond down 12, 142.18. Bottom line, the Treasury just came across what they're going to fund for the next 6 months. They are going to basically be borrowing $769 billion in the second half of the year. Big numbers. That bottom line didn't croak the Treasuries, though. Each the note and the bond, they continue to test their strength from the June 14th area. We pulled back. We'll take a look at that 10-year first. What you're going to see with the 10-year. 10-year, actually, it's May 29th. So the 10-year came down today, 905,000 contracts. That is going into 3.4 million contracts. So bottom line, you're going to need some real juice in order to get to lower price. What we haven't got yet, you know, after this downdraft from the last couple of weeks, is that you haven't got a sign of strength yet. King dollar traded down the about 350 ticks. King dollar's having a hard time holding price. That being said, as it is backing down, bottom line is that you're backing down with lighter volume. The tech stocks today, no doubt are taking the beating out there. You had Facebook going south in a big way. When it came out with its numbers, it gapped down. It's going further down out here today, and it looks to me like you get another $10, $15 on the way down. Big number. There's no two ways about that. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Give us a call, folks. Want to know what's going on in your world. Inside the NDX 100, also, volume off the high. And just bear with me for a second because my whole internet just went down. So NDX 100, Qs, they come off the high with volume. SPY, last Friday, that also came down with volume. What you have is that you have the, there we go, let's see if I can get back on here. We had the, just bear with me 1 second. Sorry about this, folks. Al, can you go to commercial?
folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
In quiet markets, investors search for new trading opportunities. We'd like to introduce you to a new product that provides opportunities even in flat markets. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a new and innovative Chicago-based exchange registered with the Commodity Futures Trading Commission. And unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their trading platform. Nadex never charges a fee to use their platform, which even includes real-time charts and full customization capability. Nadex's unique short-term binary options allow traders and investors to capitalize on strategies even when the underlying markets are quiet. Nadex's innovation has allowed them to come up with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com, or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
Until recently, it was almost impossible for the average investor to hedge against currency risk in Europe or Japan. For a bold trade on Europe or Japan that protects against moves in currency, trade HEGE or HEGJ, two times currency hedged leveraged ETFs from Direction Investments. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to The Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Now it's down 123. You get the NASDAQ off 103. S&Ps are down 14.5. You get a little acceleration coming into this last hour, folks. If we go over to the NDX 100, let's go to the NASDAQ composite. Composite. Basically, you know, four days ago, you're up at 79.33. Right now, we're at 76.34. And this is where this thing's going to get dicey, folks, and this is why. We know the February 9th high-volume swing low hasn't got tested. That number is basically a pretty intense number. You're talking about 1,000 points down from where we are right now. That number's going to get tested. The real question is that what kind of cause is going to build in order to get down into that number. Now, what we've done in basically 2 days is you come back inside the lower range. The lower range, a close under 76.37 does it. So if we go over to the NDX 100, we take a look at the NDX 100. This is what you have laying out the NDX 100. NDX 100, we're down 103 points right now. You're at 71.93. 71.86 is the number. You get back inside that, NDX 100 also hasn't tested that low, folks, and that low is 61.64. We go over into the 3Qs, and what you have here, folks, is this. So picture, the FANG stocks up and away, awesome stocks, right? Period, when they're going with you. What happens, and I suspect this is what we have happening inside the tech area in general, is Facebook falls apart. Facebook goes from $218 4 days later, you're at 166, okay? So you're talking about a major hit. What, that's $54, right? 25%. What you have out here, Facebook has a high volume low at 149. That wants to get hit. That being said, what ends up happening? Netflix, NFLX. We go to Netflix. We take a look at Netflix. Netflix is off its high, $423 to $335. Okay, just those two equities alone. Most of the large funds, folks that have been doing great out here, no doubt, they own the FANGs. When you get hit like that, what happens ASAP is that you are going to start selling other FANGs or other sector that is in that sector that you have profits in. That's what you're looking at out here. That's what seems to be happening. And the NDX 100, as the NASDAQ, they bring the market up and they bring the market down. The phenomenal thing that I've seen inside the NDX in general is that it's a mind blower how fast it can actually come back and the number of points that it can come back on. Small caps, we get over and we take a look at the small caps out here. IWM came down on volume on Friday, big volume. We did 28 million shares. You got a contraction today of 15 million. You're going to be going into 27 million, 163.31. That is the swing low that it looks like we're going to be going after. We take a look at some of the higher volume equities out here today. This is what you have happening. We have Ford Motor is up 12 cents. You get Microsoft down 238. So that's putting a beating into the NDX also. That's a large weighting structure inside the NDX. Netflix is down 20 bucks. Twitter is down 3. If we go over to Twitter, TWTR, and we take a look at Twitter. Twitter also got hit out here last week. Twitter right now is trading. Ooh, this got hit big. So Twitter is off the high of 47. You're at 31. Yeah, big number, 17 bucks. Monster volume. We take a look at Twitter, bring this back. Twitter's going right after its strength when it broke topside in February. That the bottom of that strength is $24. So it looks like in the matter of let's say 3 months, that Twitter's going to get cut in half. What we also have happening with Twitter out here today, which is really actually more dangerous, is that Twitter looks like it, yeah, it did. So Twitter broke its old uptrend that started in October at $17, and you broke it with conviction. When you break something with conviction, that's wide price spread, accelerated volume. The danger is that you can go right to the beginning where that took off topside. And man, it took off topside in a big way. We went from $17 in October of 2017, eight months ago, up to 47. Big numbers. Some of the Dow equities out here, let's take a look at them. There we go. We have Big Blue is up 45 cents. You have GE's not down anymore. You get General Motors up 20 cents. We get Disney down 20. You have Caterpillar up down actually $1.10. Boeing is the number. Boeing's putting the negative points into the Dow out here. You have Boeing is down $8.19. This came down and came down. The volume's not bad, actually. You know, we've gone from the 362 to 351. The volume isn't that bad. If we do look inside the Dow Industrials, as to the strength versus the weakness, point-wise, what you have is that you have Boeing putting 54 negative points, Visa 25, American Express 18, United Health 18. If we go over to American Express and take a look at it, it looks like American Express may have some problems out here. American Express is down to 2.5%. And American Express said an external party will conduct a review of foreign exchange business after reports that employees boosted rates for some business customers without notifying them. We take this allegation like this very seriously. A spokesman for the company said email statement Monday. If we find that we fell short on the mark, we'll fix the problem and take the appropriate actions to make sure it doesn't reoccur. Bottom line, folks, is that what I suspect you have out here is that piece by piece, you know, first you had, you know, the bottom line mortgages years ago, right? That's when the whole crash was, right? Then you had the FX fixing market, meaning currency fixing on a continual basis. More than likely, what this is going to be, it's not going to be a fixing market. What it is that when folks picture this, we're in the business, and if you're in the business, you know, for a while, you can really start understanding the different currencies. It's not that the currencies are so hard to understand, but I can absolutely see how if you're going to a different country, if you're basically buying things in other currencies, well, how do I do the conversion? You know, when I go through the numbers all the time, I'm always saying, yeah, the euro is 117 to one US dollar. The pound is 131 to one US dollar. The yen is 111 to one US dollar. What ends up happening, once you get on to what it is, it's a little bit easier because what does happen with the currencies, it's easy when it's that way. And then, you know, picture if we go over to the Canadian dollar and you look at it the other way, I'm saying to myself, okay, so $1.30 Canadian is a dollar in the US. You know, bottom line is you can see how it can get a little confusing. So I suspect what we're gonna see in American Express is more than likely they've been charging people some big money. 877-927-6648. Let's go take a look at the XAU, the HUI. XAU, trading $76.70. That's trading right into the February 9th low, as is the Gold Bugs Index. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. Our phone number is 877-927-6648. Dow's down 123. NASDAQ's off 108. S&P's down 15. Come right back.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics, including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today.
This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials right now down 141. You get the NASDAQ off 101. S&Ps are off 15 and a half. Let's go over to our man, Mr. Steve Rhodes, as we do each and every Monday at 30 past the first hour. Don't forget, folks, Steve has an outstanding show right here every trading day, 1 to 2 Eastern Standard Time. Also a great newsletter. Steve is the number one market timer in the S&P 500, according to Timers Digest. That's a big feat, folks, by the way. You can come over, check out his newsletter right at TFNN, 30-day money-back guarantee. The way you do that, you go to newsletters. You're going to go to trading newsletters. You're going to see Mastering Probability right there. Check it out. Steve Rhodes, what's going on?
Well, hey, congrats on the new office.
Yeah, we're psyched, man. I mean, you should see. I mean, you know we got a great crew. You know, yes. Tommy, Al, John, Natalie, Steve. I mean, it was just so cool, great. Man. I mean, it's, you know, folks, we were at the other office for 17 years. So this was like, you know, you talk about moving one TV studio, two radio studios. It was a trip, man.
But I predict one day you're going to pull out of the house or something, and or somebody is going to drive to the old studio.
Yeah.
Just because it's so normal,
I know, man. I know. I love it.
Hey, I thought we could just talk about a couple different things. One, the current market conditions. So if folks are watching us on Tiger TV, what they're taking a look at are the S&P 500 and the Dow. So the chart on the left-hand side of the screen is the Dow. The chart on the right-hand side is the S&P 500.
Okay.
And it's just important to always understand market conditions. So for these two indices, we're in a consolidation. The last time that we were in a protracted consolidation was back in the 2015 timeframe. Now, we didn't realize it actually began back in 2014. We didn't know that till a low had previously been tested. They can last for a long period of time. I'm not here to give the forecast of how long this consolidation will last, but the reason to bring it up is because they can be very difficult to trade. Easier to trade when prices near the top of the consolidation, such as the S&P 500 last week. It didn't get all the way up to the top, but as you know, we kind of use that area as a guideline.
Yes.
And also easier to trade when prices at the bottom of the consolidation, because it's as you like to, you've got this phrase, you know, your back is up against the wall. So on either side of the consolidation, if price breaks to either above or below, then you know the position that you may have taken is the wrong one. So we're in a difficult trading environment, which is why we've got some days, or maybe periods of days out there. You've got the sellers that are winning, and then other days where the buyers that are winning. And you were talking about currencies before you were going into your last break out there. And I like to take a look at instruments, indices, markets, commodities, as to how they're pricing in different currencies. Because let's face it, there are ES Mini traders around the globe, and they're taking a look at how the ES Mini is trading in their currency, or gold traders or oil traders. You and I, our screens, you know, our local currency is dollars. So we take a look at it. This chart here shows just the S&P 500 cash indice, shows the consolidation on the left-hand side in US dollars. What we can see is the S&P 500 priced in euros broke out. These are monthly charts, by the way. This month has broken out above that same consolidation level. So in euros, those folks that have a current local currency where they're trading the S&P 500, whether it's the SPY or the ES Mini, they can see that price has broken out. So for momentum traders, they're buying the S&P 500. It's the reason why we might have sellers in the U.S., but we also have natural buyers for folks that use the euro. With regard to the yen, it has tested, thus far rejected. You know, tomorrow's the end of the month. We'll see if price closes above that level. But in pound sterling, prices also broke. So it's made new all-time highs out here. We haven't seen that since January in the S&P 500. It's important to understand that, because when markets top, they will top in all currencies at the same time. So what this tells us, what this tells me at least, is that we are going to see new highs in the S&P 500 in cash. How long that's going to take, I don't know. We are in a consolidation. We can also look at horizontal trading ranges for the S&P 500. We can do this in the major currencies as well. By major currencies, I'm identifying the euro, the yen, and the pound sterling. There's 180 currencies out there, but these are the big ones that we pay attention. And what's interesting, we take a look at these horizontal trading ranges, and these are natural levels of support or resistance. Right now, we're really looking at resistance. This month, the month of July, the S&P 500 hit the top of its horizontal trading range. Price is about 28.49. Euro has broken out above it. But in the case of the yen and the Great British pound, it's up against some resistance right now. So watching these horizontal trading ranges will be important, not just for the month of July, but July and August and September. If they start breaking above these levels in other currencies, again, that's where you would have natural buyers, where here in the U.S., perhaps we might have natural sellers. We can also look at the Dow. So that was the S&P 500. Here what we can see in the Dow, the consolidation on the left in U.S. dollars, but in euros, we've made a new all-time high this month in July. Same thing in pounds. In the case of yen hasn't tested its all-time high just yet. So it's as if yen traders are more focused on the S&P than they are in the Dow. Now, the important thing here is that the Dow is kind of like the big trophy horse out there for traders across the globe. So if the Dow starts breaking out in all these major currencies, that's going to be a big tell to us as to what the Dow is going to be doing in dollars. One of the things, now, that I was working with Tommy just earlier today, one of the things I'm going to do for subscribers is put together a workshop, Tom. It's going to be 2 weeks from tomorrow, August the 7th. And I have created a market analyzer. It goes out and it screens all types of markets out there, and it uses the exact same tools that I use in order to be able to garner that number one ranking by Timer Digest for the S&P 500. So we don't have it up on our members page, but I wanted to spend just a few minutes here just to talk to viewers, listeners out there, because they can sign up for my newsletter service and get these type of signals and then be able to access the workshop that I do a week from this coming Tuesday on August the 7th out there. And what my system does, this helps all types of traders. If you're a stock picker, my system here, what I'm showing, takes a look and gives the market signals. Some of those signals I've broken bullish signals down into five different categories. And what we're looking at in the daily outlook here, it says bull over. That means the run of the bull is over. This would suggest that you would take your profits and even consider taking short positions. Here it's showing Adobe, Alexion Pharmaceuticals, Biogen, Facebook is on there. It also shows that the bear market is over. Now, I'm using bull and bear as a directional standpoint. So here it's showing the bear is over for Randgold. It's suggesting that Randgold may be a buy. You have to do some additional analysis on this. But the system actually gives you the buy points out here. You'll see something that says the daily TAS support and daily OUL support, 7226, 7339. So I have an entire system. I'm going to do a workshop, as I say, on August the 7th that'll teach people how to be able to utilize all the tools with inside the newsletter for those folks looking for new ideas, whether it's equity futures, commodities, indices around the world. It's got everything in there.
It's a beautiful thing.
Congrats on the new office. I can't wait to see it.
Yeah, totally, man. Listen, thank you so much. You have a great one, safe one. Of course, we look forward to the workshop, and we look forward to the show tomorrow.
Thanks, Sam.
Thanks, Steve. Stay right there, folks. Come right back. We have the Dow Industrials right now down 128. NASDAQ is off 99. S&Ps are off 13. Come right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
The Path of Least Resistance, David White's daily market letter, gives you trade recommendations based on David's proprietary power law vector indicator that put the odds of success overwhelmingly in your favor. He'll give you the entry price, price target, and stop price for each stock and option trade. David combines his years of trading experience along with his background in technology and computing to offer his subscribers his take on the markets on a daily basis. Every trading day by 9:30, David publishes his morning issue of The Path of Least Resistance, along with updates sent out throughout the week whenever there is new actionable trading information. All new subscribers receive a 30-day, no-questions-asked money-back guarantee. To sign up for David White's daily trading newsletter right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find The Path of Least Resistance under Trading Newsletters.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials down 141. You get the NASDAQ off 102. S&Ps are down 14. And, of course, it is the NDX 100 and the NASDAQ that has the big numbers on the way down. We go over to Apple. So, Apple, folks, tomorrow 4:30 is going to be coming out with numbers. Apple right now is trading $190 even. And if we pull this back, I mean, Apple's still at highs. So bottom line is that we'll see how this shakes out. You know, that being said, what Apple also has and has never got tested is this February 9th high volume swing low. And that's a huge danger. I mean, it's a monster danger, too. In fact, if I take Apple, one second, and put this up. Yeah, this is a classic. What you're going to see with Apple, I'll put this in a little neater for you. What you're going to see with Apple is that when we broke down on February 9th, and a lot of the equities had this, this is a classic that you break with conviction, meaning, okay, so your trend line, I can bring a trend line right from November of 2016, Apple was $104. So watch how this shakes out. This is pretty intense. You broke the trend, the uptrend, when in February, you know, bottom line, most stocks got basically taken to the cleaners pretty quick, and they came back just as quick. In Apple's case, you went from $179.44 January 26th, and you were at 150 2 weeks later. You know, so bottom line, $30, right, for $180 stock, big numbers. Now, what ends up happening? It goes all the way back up, and what it has done is test the underside of the trend line that it broke. So that is a big danger point, no two ways about it. The way that Apple is set up right now, I don't expect you're going to get down to the bottom of this, but I do expect it's going to work its way down to this 150 area, and you're at 189. The high of the low is 163, so 163 could be game. But if you come into that with too much volume, guess what? You're going south. You get the Manafort trial is starting tomorrow. This is a big number, so check this number out. This is going to be pretty wild. The special counsel Robert Mueller said it starts tomorrow. I guess they're going to start filing paperwork tonight. Bottom line is that they're going to try to prove that he made $60 million in political consulting in the Ukraine, you know, big number. No two ways about that. We'll see where this whole baby shakes out. That is one monster number, though. My God, huge. 877-927-6648. Let's go over and we'll take a look at Tesla. Let's see when Tesla's coming out with their numbers. Tesla. Oh, August 1st, it's going to be good. Okay, so August 1st, Wednesday, Tesla's coming out with its numbers. Tesla is down off its highs from 373. That high was generated in June. We put this back. Tesla right now is trading 290, and Tesla has this high volume low. And okay, so what Tesla's also done is this, folks. So when you go into either a high volume low or high volume high, when you go into that bar, the bottom line is if you go into the bar a longer period of percentage, your probability gets much higher, you're going to go to the bottom of the bar. Well, that's exactly what we've done on Tesla, and the low is 244 of the April bar. This looks like it's going to basically make its way down to that level. We put this on a monthly for a second. So on a monthly, yeah, we're set up the same way. Even when, you know, what's intriguing with Tesla is that it had some good volume in June. Yeah, in June, not July. But it still couldn't make its high. Tesla wants to go test that low. So that's going to be a big number. Amazon's still hanging high. You know, we're down $39, but that's, you're talking about an $1,770 stock. Pull this back. Yeah, and they definitely are not getting away from Amazon just yet. Google, we take a look at Google. Now, what's intriguing about Google is this. Google was one of the first equities to test its February 9th high volume swing low. And what did it did? It, what did it do? It tested it and then took off like a rocket ship. You'll see on a weekly basis, we had 15.9 million shares. Price was $9.92. It did a bounce all the way up to 11.77 and then came all the way back down, tested it at 9.80. You had the test at 11.8 million versus 15.9. Takes off topside. And then what Google did do, also, when it came up with numbers, you had the wide price spread, you had volume, you had all of that, and it's going to be pretty hard to break down Google. I mean, you're going to be able to break lower, but I would say that in those FANG stocks, Google and Amazon look pretty good. Let's look at Netflix for a second, because they've been definitely selling Netflix. So if we put Netflix up on a weekly, you're at 334. Yeah, that's a problem. So change this to a monthly. So on a monthly basis, yeah, 286 is game. Because this is where the aspect is that when you go up so fast and so high, and there's no foundation in the middle of it, meaning no support. A foundation would be that you're trading sideways for a period of time, building cars for the next leg up. It's problematic, folks, when you go up that fast, if you don't get out, because you can get down just as fast, because there's no floors that it's laid out, that you've had that battle between the bulls and bears, and you have the accumulation distribution going on, and that is the true way that you get some decent support in equities when they're coming down. You know, it looks to me like a few of, well, more than a few of them, because we did go up so fast, so dramatically, that just the other way is pretty easy. We're going to take a look at Walmart. Walmart's having trouble too. Walmart's up 73 cents today. You're off this high of 109, you're at 88. And you're coming right into the downdraft off the highs. This went straight down from $109. 5 weeks later, it was at 87. That's going to take a lot of juice to get through that area. And what we will see, what we saw last week is that we saw a contraction of volume as we was trying to get into those levels. The 30-year note market. Let's go take a look at the note market. So notes and bonds have been trading into their strength from May. They keep rejecting lower price. They haven't got any strength yet. And out here today, you get 217,000 contracts. It's a good number, because meaning that that's tremendously lighter volume compared to what we're coming into. We're coming into 602,000 contracts. Last week we even did 257, the rejected price. It's been rejecting price here since the downdraft of the 23rd. Of July. That came down pretty quick. What's intriguing is that now the Treasury has come out saying exactly what they plan on borrowing, and it didn't hit the note or bond market. The Treasury plans on borrowing $793 billion within the next 6 months. And that borrowing, folks, it's the funding. They'll need some of it to fund. They need most of it to roll over the bonds that are basically coming due. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com under Trading Newsletters. Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a 2-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your 2-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, the opening call, today by visiting TFNN.com. TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. 877-927-6648. Let's go to Rich in Oregon. Hey, Rich, what's going on, brother?
Hey, I hope I'm the first to call in on your new show in Clearwater.
You are. In St. Petersburg. We moved
from St. Petersburg. Okay.
Yeah. Well, no, you thank
know,
you.
Us folks out here in Oregon, our phone lines aren't that good yet. We're still
no, thank you. We moved from Clearwater to St. Petersburg, yes.
Okay, well, congratulations.
Thanks, man. Appreciate it.
So, well, I wanted to talk about Toll Brothers because I just heard that, you know, the home builders' confidence level just plummeted for 10 months, according to the news media. Yet Toll Brothers announced that they're going to build 22 homes in Surprise, Arizona.
Let's take a look.
Is this the top?
I don't think so. This has been, so watch this. This is the low for the year is 34, which right at it. The high is 52. If we pull this back, what you're going to be looking at here, I'm going to put this on a weekly basis. So what you see is that, you know, we go back to 2016, Toll Brothers at $24. Makes a run all the way up to 52. And that being said, though, we have pulled back, I think it's just about a 50% retracement. Let me look at this. Just... whoops, close that one. Whoops. Actually, a 61% retracement. Okay, so you got a 61%, which is a deep retracement.
Yeah.
There's no doubt. When you pull this up, though, what you're going to see is that you're coming right into where you've had, you know, a huge consolidation. We consolidated this area from September of 2012 going all the way over to December of 2013. You know, so, I mean, it's not broken down yet. You know, this month you're down so far as 40 million shares. You're going into 65 million. Yeah. So are you looking to buy or sell it?
Looking to sell if it's going to follow what they're saying.
Don't do it yet.
All right.
Okay, have a great
Thanks,
one.
Tom.
Have a safe one.
Stay right there, folks. Again.
Thanks so much, man. Appreciate it. Stay right there, folks. Coming back with some numbers after the close.
You know what's cool? Taking something that's good for you. Something specifically formulated to help with weight loss, better sleep, stress reduction, and the need to detox.
Nico, our hunter and gatherer ancestors found all their nutritional requirements for health in their wild environment. But today, our food sources no longer contain the vitamins, minerals, and nutrients our bodies need to stay healthy and strong.
That's why we need Primal Edge Daily Nutrition. It includes a special blend of ionic, soil-based vitamins, minerals, fatty, and amino acids in an easy-to-use liquid form.
Primal Edge is powered by highly concentrated folic and humic acids, nature's preferred delivery system. They've been called miracle molecules because, like sunlight, air, and water, life cannot exist without them.
That's right, Paige. They ensure we receive all the nutrition we need to be healthy and thrive.
We take it every morning.
Primal Edge, formulated and approved by Nico and Paige of Living a Primal Lifestyle. Buy it today for just $89. Click on the Primal Edge banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
The following is a presentation of TFNN. The Tom O'Brien Show is produced every business day. Tom takes your phone calls toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Oh, look who we have.
It's a beautiful thing. Look at our man, Jim from Minneapolis. We are taken by storm.
Taking it by storm, baby.
I love that. That's a great saying, man. Hey, what's happening, brother?
Good morning, gentlemen. How you guys doing today?
Good, man. Yourself?
Oh, man. It's been the most incredible couple of days since when I called in on Friday, Litecoin busted out of that consolidation on the two-hour chart.
Okay.
And it just never looked back. It did a 100-point ABC up, and now it's very extended the way I look at it. But
yeah.
Holy, I mean, it went up to $420 last night.
Now, Tom O'Brien.
Welcome, folks. This is Tom O'Brien of TFNN. We go 5 days a week. We go 10 hours a day. We go 24 hours a day on the internet at TFNN.com. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. Hope everyone's having a great day, safe day. Let's make it a great night, folks. Yesterday's gone. Tomorrow's not here. What are you doing right now? Market-wise, let's take a look at it out here. We had the Dow Industrials down 144, NASDAQ down 107, S&P's off 14.5, gold contract down $2.80, trading at $12.20 an ounce. Silver up a penny, $15.51. Both gold and silver still struggle to get a bid. Oil got a bid out here today. Oil's going to need more volume in order to get higher, though. We are up $1.30 in the oil market, $69.99 for a barrel of light sweet crude. Notes and bonds. Notes and bonds, you get the 10-year note down 2, 119.11. 30-year bond down 11, 142.19. Both notes and bonds continue to reject lower price as it's coming into its strength that was generated out here on May 29th. May 29th, folks, that's when the note and bond market took off topside with volume. The 10-year note went from 119.11 up to 121, and we did 3.4 million contracts, big number. Today, we did a million contracts back and into that area. Now, that being said, you know, this has been going on for the past five trading days. We've been in this area. The volume is contracting dramatically and has contracted. What we haven't got yet is a flat-out rejection of lower price with lighter volume than a sign of strength. Right? We closed out here today at 119.11 in the 30-year. That's exactly the number that is the low of that. So that's what you basically are looking for, to come down to that number. hit that number and then say, I don't want to be at that number and get out of there. The 10-year closed right at it today. 30 years, a little bit stronger. The low of that number in the 30-year is 142.14. What we did do is that we got to 142.12, closing out at 142.19. That's coming into, we did 222,000 contracts. That is coming into 602,000 contracts. Still, that being said, you're only five ticks away from it. So that is not getting away from it. When you want to do a test, folks, particularly in a big bar like that, you want to come into the bar, you want to hit the bottom of the bar, you want to reject it with lighter volume, and then get out of there that day. We haven't seen that yet. King dollar. Same setup in King dollar, meaning that this has been a long consolidation. This consolidation started when we go all the way back to May 29th. What King dollar did do out here today, it comes back. Volume, however, contracting in a big way. Now, it didn't hold price, so that is saying that it's going to have another shot to basically try to get into the lows of the last swing point. Lows of the last swing point was generated on July 9th. That's 93,440. Right now, you're at 94,155. We did 12,000 contracts today. That's light volume on this pullback. Some of the higher volume equities out here, you had Twitter down 279. Facebook was off 383. Microsoft was down 231. You had Netflix down 20. Big numbers are right there. CBS was down 273. We had, that's on the way down. On the way up, we had Citicorp up 60 cents. You had Pfizer up 18 cents. We had Chesapeake Energy up 26 cents. Bank of America is up 25, and Advanced Micro is up 48. If we do go over, and let's go take a look at Microsoft. So Microsoft's been on a heck of a run. Microsoft out here today pulls back, has some volume in the pullback. Microsoft topped out 3 days ago at 111, you're at 105. Put this on a weekly. That's not the end of the world. This is quite a chart. We were at $57 in September of 2016. Hits a high of 111. And you're talking a Microsoft that has 7.6 billion shares outstanding. Can you imagine having 7.6 billion shares outstanding? That is so far over the top, it's unbelievable. Pretty intense. The XLK, let's go take a look at the XLF rather. XLF, the financials. Bottom line, coming right into its downdraft, can't handle it. You know, this has been a consolidation that started out in March. Started in February. February, the high volume swing low, 26.76. Does a nice bounce up to 29.81. Gives it up again. Hits a low of 26.46. Now what you're doing is you're trying to get into the downdraft that had been created out here on the week of February 5th to the 9th. The February 9th number, folks, is a big number. That's the real bottom line. Specifically, what I'm talking about is that number wants to get tested. It's got tested in many equities already. The real danger for the Qs, for the NDX 100, is that it is going to get tested, because where the high volume low is in the Qs is $150, and we're at 175 right now. Big number. What the Qs have done, they have come off the highs with volume. They got back inside their lower range today. 175.21 is the beginning of the lower range. What that sets up is that now that sets up that the Qs can get down to 153.88. That being said, guess what? That high volume low is sticking out like a sore thumb, and what I do expect is that we are going to get that tested. It's going to be pretty intense if we actually get down there, because if we get down there, that means that a few of these NDX stocks are going to just be destroyed. Why? Because of the weighting structure. You know, we already had Facebook, looks like it's down 25% in 4 days. We just went from $218 to $171. We hit $166 today. If I bring this back, what you're going to see is that you get a high volume low at $149. And there's nothing to stop going to 149. We also have, and this is going to be set up in a lot of these equities, is that when we broke down on the 9th of February, what you're going to see is that this is a classic break of a trend with conviction. And then what you do after you break it, you go back and touch and test the lower part of the trend line. And that's exactly what we did. We broke down on February 9th first, went to 167, and that was from the week prior from 195. You go much lower, we go to 149, have volume there, and then take off like a rocket ship to 149 to an all-time high last week of 218. Now, we take a look at this, you're watching Tiger TV, that sets up that we can get down into this 162 to 149, which is the bar from the March 10th area. Stay right there, folks, come right back.
Hi, folks, Tom O'Brien here. If you'd like to get my daily newsletter, Market Insights, then now is a great time to sign up for a 30-day free trial. Every morning by 9:30, I send out my morning letter to subscribers with market commentary on a variety of markets, currencies, and commodities to keep investors up to date on the day's trading action. Included in Market Insights are specific buy and sell recommendations for stocks, ETFs, and even options, with stops and price targets included for every trade in my newsletter. If you'd like to try my newsletter risk-free for 30 days, then head over to the front page of TFNN and you'll find Market Insights under Trading Newsletters. I use my years of trading experience to bisect and dissect the market every morning and give my subscribers the most important information they need to know for the day ahead. I even issue afternoon updates for my subscribers whenever warranted with important market action. I'm always scouring the market for the next great trading opportunity. Sign up for your 30-day free trial to my daily newsletter, Market Insights, today by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Wow! Go get them, folks.
Has the current market volatility continued to stop you out of trades when the market spikes against you? Now is the perfect time to open up an account with Nadex. Nadex, the North American Derivatives Exchange, is a brand new, completely regulated Chicago-based exchange, and unlike most other exchanges, Nadex allows you to trade directly through them with direct market access when using their completely free trading platform, which also features real-time charts and full customization capability. One of the advantages of trading with Nadex in volatile markets is that your risk is always capped and you have the ability of keeping your trades open even when the market spikes against you. Nadex is completely brand new with a line of unique trading products that are unavailable anywhere else. See how it works at Nadex.com. That's Nadex.com. Or click on the Nadex banner on the front page of TFNN.com. Futures and options trading involves risk and may not be appropriate for all investors.
Are China A-shares hot or not? If you trade China A-shares, now may be time to take a closer look. Trade CHAU or CHAD, Direction's daily CSI 300 China A-share bull and bear ETFs. China A-shares in either direction. Visit directioninvestments.com today. An investor should consider the investment objectives, risks, charges, and expenses of the Direction shares carefully before investing. The prospectus and summary prospectus contain this and other information about Direction shares. To obtain a prospectus or summary prospectus, please contact Direction shares at 866-476-7523. The prospectus or summary prospectus should be read carefully before investing. An investment in the funds is subject to risk, including the possible loss of principal. The funds are designed to be utilized only by sophisticated investors such as traders and active investors. Distributor Foreside Fund Services, LLC.
Tom, take your phone calls. Now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Welcome back, folks. Dow Industrials are finished down 144. NASDAQ was off 107. S&P's off 14.5. Let's go over to the XLF. So the XLF, of course, to the financials, folks, what we did out here today is that we got up to the top of the consolidation. This has been consolidating for quite some time. The top of the consolidation we're talking about here is 2845. We got to 2835. Bottom line, couldn't handle that price. That thing looks like it's still going to pull back. So if we take a look at that, we'll go to Berkshire Hathaway first, because Berkshire is still, BRK, the largest weighting structure inside the XLF. Berkshire, yeah, where Berkshire goes, the XLF goes. So Berkshire Hathaway 6 months ago is at 217. You're at 199. You did have a sign of strength 2 weeks ago. That's when we popped up to 201. That being said, guess what? You couldn't even take out a swing point. The swing point is the 202. Yeah, this is pretty intense. You swing point in this consolidation in May was $202.41. You know, when we popped higher, we got to 201.40, couldn't even take it out. And that's problematic. What I found is that if you are coming into swing areas and, you know, you get a nice pop like that after basically coming down, it's been coming down for 6 months, and you can't take out the swing point, it's a big deal. It's a big deal. The J.P. Morgan, let's go take a look at J.P. Morgan. That's a high weighting structure inside the XLF. Now, that's a little bit different. J.P. Morgan last month has just gone from 102 to 116. That being said, guess what? When you start looking at this, this looks like it's going to test its highs, though. So when you look at J.P. Morgan, you'll see that you had the high volume low from February 9th, $101, $103. And 98 cents. 4 weeks later, you go from 103, you make a new high at 119. So $17, right? Not bad. 16% up. Then what do? You come all the way back down and test the high volume low of February. And we did that the week of July 6th. Excuse me, folks. Sorry about that. And so even with the holiday, because the volume contracted so dramatically, it still was a good test, because what you have is that you did 42 million versus 140 in the week of July 4th. You got to add a day and a half of volume to the 3.5 days, because we are closed for a day and a half. That being said, what we had out here today is that gets the higher price, can't handle it, and he had a monster contraction of volume, huge. BAC, Bank of America. Let's take a look at BAC. Same kind of setup. Interesting. Yeah. These all, you know, these Bank of America has been also consolidating since that downdraft that started in February. We take a look at Goldman Sachs. Goldman Sachs is even weaker. It's pretty wild. You know, Goldman Sachs is trading back where we were trading in December of 2016. That's a long period of time. When we take a look at Goldman Sachs out there. Gold Bugs Index. So let's take a look at this Gold Bugs Index. What has happened is that, and this is where there's a real danger point inside the HUI, XAU, all of the above. And this is what it is. The Gold Bugs Index is trading 165.36. Well, that's coming into the downdraft from December of 2016. And when we came out of that December 2016 area, that was a nice little pop. I mean, the Gold Bugs Index went from 160 in December, week of December 16th, up to 222, nonstop deal. That being said, on the way back down, this is where the danger is. The XAU has not done what the Gold Bugs Index is doing. The XAU, I'll bring this up in a second, but the XAU has held its December 2017 swing lows, where the HUI has not. So the number to keep your eye on here is 160.25. Yeah, it's 160.25. And there's the HUI, XAU. We put the XAU up. Okay, so it's down 10 cents today. Yeah, it's 76.68. So 75.65 is the number in the XAU, meaning that to keep it inside the range. Right now you're down 10 cents. 75, oh, look at that, 75, it's only 3 pennies from where we are. You know, different setup. And now, and what we do have inside that market is that, and that's why you want to watch both of them pretty closely, you know, because the XAU has to do with the amount of gold that is hedged going forward in the marketplace. And what we have had inside the physical gold market, the jewelry market, is that, you know, the demand has gone down substantially in India. India and China are always the largest buyers of gold. The India deal is intriguing, and I don't think it will come back for a while because of the fact that their real estate market had gone topside in a huge way, folks. And that thing is coming back like a big time, you know, and it's been coming back for quite some time. China, what has happened in China, China is still there. It's pulled back somewhat in the last quarter, meaning the amount of physical gold that was bought, but not that much, because that's a great way for all the Chinese to get their money out of the country. And the government, you know, knows that that is going on, and that's they're trying to make that as hot as possible. So when you're talking about a fundamental supply and demand, bottom line is that it's not that the supply is higher, but the demand has not come through in China, nor has it come through in India. And you think those are two highest users of gold and silver, because of course they use their wealth with it, they have jewelry, and over there what ends up happening is that, which is pretty amazing, you're paying for the gold content, not so much the jewelry, you're paying for the gold content, which is pretty intriguing, there's no doubt. 877-927-6648. Let's go take a look at the Rangold Resources. So Rangold, that's trading up 55 cents. Let's see, they just released some numbers. So Rangold Resources said labor strikes at Ivory Coast. Tongan Mine will reduce the mine's output for the year to 250,000 to 255. CEO Mark Bristow told reporters in the country's commercial capital. Originally the target of the mine's output for the year was 290,000. So bottom line is that market-wise, it looks that the market was expecting that to happen, because when that came across the tape this afternoon, that didn't push the equity down. You know, bottom line, the low of the day was 73.10, closed out at 73.53, and the Rangold Resources had been one of the strongest gold stocks. And you're talking about a run for about 13, 14 years. So it's going to be intriguing, you know, to see if they can basically do it again. You know, what I have found is that when an equity makes a run, it can do it 4 or 5 years, this thing gold market, and then all of a sudden it disappears, and then it's just a normal equity. Stay right there, folks. Come right back.
Today, it's hard to tell if the economy is coming or going. Regardless, I want my money going in the direction I choose. If that's your stance as well, then you want to know how EverBank can help keep your money thriving just the way you want. Is growing your money a priority? EverBank is committed to a yield pledge promise to pay high yields on your checking, money market, and CD balances. Looking to diversify? EverBank ingeniously developed accessible ways to spread your money around the world into foreign currencies and even non-FDIC insured metals. And when it comes to your wealth, they bring a highly experienced and global perspective to help you manage it. EverBank's financial philosophy flies in the face of the status quo. They believe your money's performance should not be determined by today's economic circumstances, but by the drive to rise above them and create opportunities that favor your objectives. If that excites you, like it does me, call 1-855-750-4051 to find out what they can do for you. That's 1-855-750-4051. Call them today. EverBank is a member FDIC and Equal Housing Lender.
No matter what kind of trader you are, 2018 is a great time to try out a subscription to Tom O'Brien's Gold Report. Whether you just plan on diversifying your portfolio with some exposure to gold and gold mining equities, or you're a gold bull that sees 2018 as the year of commodities, now is a great time to sign up for the Gold Report. Tom O'Brien publishes his Gold Report every Monday morning before the market opens and covers a variety of topics including gold, silver, platinum, copper, the XAU and HUI, the dollar, bonds, South African rand, as well as more than 20 of the most actively traded mining equities. Start your 2018 off with a bang and sign up for the Gold Report today. The Gold Report is a long-term newsletter where the focus is on building real wealth through the management of a successful portfolio of gold stocks. For all the details and to start your subscription right now, visit the front page of TFNN.com and you'll find the Gold Report under Investment Newsletters.
TFNN has put together the finest programming lineup each trading day, featuring some of the most knowledgeable and respected financial minds in the nation to educate traders and investors. On Mondays, Wednesdays, and Fridays, we broadcast 8 hours a day, starting at 9 a.m. as Larry Pesavento kicks us off with Trade What You See. Tuesdays and Thursdays, we broadcast 11 hours. Get an early and healthy start to your day as Nico and Paige bring you Living a Primal Lifestyle. Then catch Andy Hecht at 5 p.m. with the Commodities Hour following the Tom O'Brien Show. Swim lessons from TD Ameritrade Thinkorswim is now at 11 a.m., followed by Basil Chapman at 12 noon. See the TFNN program lineup via the link on the front page of TFNN.com to get a complete overview of our TFNN shows and hosts, and keep TFNN's Tiger TV tuned in on your mobile device, PC, or Mac for the latest financial news and information throughout the broadcasting day. TFNN.com, educating investors. This segment is brought to you by Think or Swim. For more information, just click the Think or Swim banner on the front page of TFNN.com.
Welcome back, folks. Dow down 144, NASDAQ off 107, S&P's off 13.5. And if we do go over and take a look at the volume inside the NYSE first, folks, we came down at 749 versus 777 on Friday. So that's not an expansion of volume. The NQ, the NASDAQ composite, has about the same amount of volume. We came down at $2.18 billion on Friday, $2.136 today. And if we do take a look at that composite, what you're going to see, the composite did get back inside the lower range. The lower range that we're talking about is 63.37. It's pretty amazing how fast that you can get back to something like that. That range there was the high that was generated on March 13th. NDX 100, we take a look at the NDX, and you're going to see the same type of setup inside the NDX. I believe the NDX also go back inside its lower range. NDX is trading 71.93. Yeah, oh no, no, that's 71.86. So the NDX has further lower to go in order to basically get back inside that lower range. We did trade down to 71.58 today. We closed, however, at 71.93. The big danger for both the NDX and the NASDAQ are those February 9th high volume swing lows. They were going to get tested. If I go to the small caps, it's the same number. And these numbers are huge, folks. It's just like, because the run has been extraordinary in general. The run in the last 6 months was a one-way route, topside, right from the February 9th low. You know, I just brought up the small caps. And what you can see with the small caps, same setup. It's the February 9th. The IWM, let's say the small caps, or the ETF for the small caps, the IWM, it's trading 164.20. The low is 142. Bottom line, that baby wants to get tested. If we do take a look at, this is a classic also. If we take a look at this and we do the channels from highs to lows, what you're going to see is that you broke your up channel. You broke it in February. You broke down, you have a high volume low. You go all the way back up, and it takes, March, April, May, June. Oh, my God, March. It takes 5 months. Man, time's really wild. So we take 5 months to come back up to the trend line. We tuck our head underneath the trend line. The volume contracts, and you start pulling back. So in both of those cases, let me go look at the Dow Industrials and see. I don't believe the Dow, yeah, it is, that's, they're all down there quite a bit. The Dow Industrials never tested. Oh, no, hold on 1 second. Because the Dow topped out in January, yeah, wouldn't have as much to go. So the Dow Industrials, your number's 23,360. You're at 25 right now. Because you got to remember something, that the Dow Industrials topped out the week of January 26th. The week of January 26th, we hit 2661. Next week, 2660. So we'll see how this shakes out. But that high volume low is hanging out there in a big way, and that's 23,360. And that is 23,000. Put that back up again. That's 2,000 points. Just make sure of that. 23,360. Yeah, 2,000 points. Monster number. Monster number, folks. And there's no doubt that we're going to have some more numbers out. We just got the bond numbers for the next 6 months. Market just shook it off. The Treasury is going to be wanting funded for $796 billion. Market, when you take a look at that, looks like it can basically shake it off, though, because that came out at 4:15 this afternoon. And those refunding deals are a big deal, folks, because what ends up happening is this, is that you have plenty of notes and bonds that are in the market. I believe that the one they're going to be doing right now is the 5-year refunding. So they're going to be looking to push 5-year notes out because they're bringing in so much of the debt. You know, bottom line, though, we know how the debt goes. Each and every month, this debt has been going up. And what we are going to see out here this year, I suspect, is that it's going to go up quite a bit because there's the impact of the tax cut. The tax cut's going to basically not more than likely get as much money inside the coffers. What's going to be really intriguing is this. You got to remember that there's two different aspects, not of the tax cut. You know, tax cut, bottom line, people have to pay less taxes, so it's less taxes going to the Treasury. But what you also have is that this market was on a one-way route on the way up. So more than likely, what we had last year is that you had people paying capital gains. This year, that money won't come in for another 4 or 5 months. Bottom line, I expect some people to be selling here, particularly because when you see a Facebook get hit, then you see a Netflix get hit, the bottom line is that a lot of people own those FANG stocks, they're gonna wanna just get out. And then what I expect we are gonna see right now, Amazon and Google, they've been holding up tough. I expect you're going to get some pressure inside those equities. The reason being is that most traders understand they don't want to be the last one out the door because of the fact, picture it for a second, we're in August 1st, Wednesday. Well, a money manager can look at himself or herself and say, hey, listen, I'm already up enough. Why don't I just clean the decks out here, put the money in short-term overnight banks, get a small amount of interest, it's tiny, no doubt about that, but guess what? You already made the year. You do that, what ends up happening? If, in fact, we continue to pull back like we've been pulling back, then you're really going to look like a hero because you got to remember something. Money managers get scored on their benchmarks, and that is the benchmark at the end of the year. So two different things end up happening. If you get a nice run on the way up, which we got, if you get out and the market just even goes flat, you're going to look really good. If you get out and the market pulls back, you're going to look like a genius. That's just how it goes. They do get only paid for the aspect, well, this would be financial planners. They get paid for the aspect of money in the market, not cash in the market. Plenty of hedge funds, however, get paid on what they can put in your pocket. And that's where this thing comes to play. And it comes to play in a big way. The let's go to a Caterpillar. So Caterpillar came out with numbers. Caterpillar traded, started out at 145, closed out at 139. Yeah, it's a consolidation too. Let's see what they had to say inside their numbers there. Okay, so the estimate was $2.73. They made $2.97. Good number. Gross revenue, they had estimated $13.98 billion. They did $14 billion. So they had some decent numbers. If we take a look at this technically, put this on a weekly. Yeah, this is bottom line. It's going to need a few more signs of strength, but it is pushing into higher leverage with volume. Stay right there, folks. We're coming right back. We had the Dow Industrials close down 144, NASDAQ up 107, S&P's down 13.5. Come right back.
Many of our new listeners have heard about The Tiger's Den. The Tiger's Den is a lively community where professional traders and investors can meet, exchange ideas and information in a comfortable, moderated atmosphere. Hear all of the TFNN shows, plus see all of the charts as they happen live and have access to archives of all of those charts. You can test drive The Tiger's Den absolutely free for 30 days and greatly enrich your knowledge of these markets and how to make your money work for you. Details on The Tiger's Den are on the front page of TFNN.com. Tiger TV is an exciting way to experience TFNN programming. See high-definition video giving you crystal-clear charts, as well as seeing some of the faces of TFNN's highly acclaimed financial experts with crisp, full-fidelity sound. Catch Tom O'Brien, John Logan, Steve Rhodes, Basil Chapman, Larry Pesavento, Think or Swim, David White, Andy Hecht, and Daryl Martin in crystal-clear, high-definition audio and video. Tiger TV, exclusively at TFNN.com.
Since 1984, Basil Chapman has been using the Chapman Wave methodology to advise traders of his expert market opinion. While originally hand-drawing charts from the late 1970s into the 1980s, Basil noticed that prices under most circumstances virtually always had a certain number of legs to the upside before declining sharply. Later, Basil found that computer software, which included the standard market technical indicators, enhanced the degree of accuracy in calling price turns as well as market trend calls. Thus was born the Chapman Wave sequence. Using the Chapman Wave methodology along with other indicators, Basil Chapman advises his subscribers of his expert market opinion each market day with his opening call newsletter. Right now, you can get a two-week free trial to the opening call, Basil's daily trading newsletter, by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Cancel at any time during that trial and pay absolutely nothing. Get your two-week free trial to Basil's newsletter, The Opening Call, today by visiting TFNN.com.
I'm certain you are or strive to be one of the best of the best at everything you do in life. It's the most common trait that we tigers and tigresses share. If you're looking to become the best of the best when it comes to managing your money, let me teach you to do what most wealth managers tell you can't be done, which is how to time the markets. I'm Steve Rhodes, author of Mastering Probability, and for the last 12 months, Timer Digest has been tracking my newsletter signals, which have earned me the ranking as their number one market timer in the nation for the S&P 500 for the last 12, 6, and 3 months. Timer Digest also ranks me as the number one market timer for gold as well. The fact is, markets can be timed, and I'll teach you the exact set of tools that I use that has transformed me into one of the best at what I do. Sign up for Mastering Probability today by clicking on the newsletter tab on the homepage of TFNN.com and get immediate access to workshops where I take you step by step how to use an extraordinary set of tools as well as provide great market calls too. Sign up today.
Tom, take your phone calls now. Toll free at 1-877-927-6648. Internationally at 727-445-1044.
Tom O'Brien.
Welcome back, folks. Let's go take a look at a few equities that just came out with numbers. We have Nutrisystems. Nutrisystems closed at $38.50. The low for the year is $26. The high is $60. We're at $38 right now. After the close was $37.50. Let's see what they have to say. Okay, their earnings per share, the estimate was $0.81. They made $0.87. Estimate, $188 million. They made $191. Okay, not bad. Let's go see what that chart looks like, though. Okay, so this chart, filling this gap. Well, it's way off its highs, though. 67 is highs, it's at 38. Yeah, this thing's going to have a hard time getting to 42. That's a vicious downdraft. We went from $42 to $28 on a weekly, the week of March 2nd. So that has some problems. Alumina, this equity, this closed at $289. It was down $11.91. This has a low of $170 for the year, past 12 months, high of $317. This is trading at $307, so this is up like $8. This is pretty wild. This equity actually looks like the NDX 100. This was a straight shot up. It was trading 121, December of 2016, just go straight up to 317. This looks like it's going to be in trouble here. Well, when I say trouble, $251 is the next stop on the way down. Big number. VRSN, let's see. Whoops. This is VeriSign. VeriSign closed down $4.83 at 145. It's trading 145.43, trading right where it closed. I'm not sure if this doesn't look like it came out with its numbers. Now, let's get into the Treasury bills. This is going to be intriguing. So, pitch it, folks, is that it's all about supply and demand. As to how many bills are actually out there printed off the U.S. Treasury, how many dollars are chasing them, and at what price are they chasing them? You know, because when we still look, this is what gets so intriguing about how the debt versus the debt across the world is basically priced out at. Our 10-year yield right now is 2.973. Bottom line, you can lend the government money for 10 years, that's the rate you're going to get. If you're in France, you get 0.7%. If you're in Italy, you get 1.4%. This is where this thing gets whacked out, because it's like, we have so much debt, there's no doubt. I can picture that, you know, why our interest rate is higher. But it would almost seem that everyone would be putting their money into these bonds or notes because of the fact that they're so much higher than they are in almost every other first world country. So Treasury comes out today, actually 10 minutes before 4, and they have their funding needs. Well, their funding needs this time, they're pretty extensive. They're going to issue $329 billion in net marketable debt from July through September. That is higher than the estimate of $273 billion that was estimated in April. And then they are going to, so that brings us till July, till September. Then they're going to issue an additional $440 million that gets you into the second half of December. This is the kicker now. That is the highest that they have actually issued since the Depression. Now, I'm talking about the Depression of 2007. So this is the highest that in July to December of 2008, the Treasury issued $1.1 trillion. This time we're going to be $763 billion, I believe. The yields on the 10-year, they are laying right at the, right below the 3%. 10-year right now is 2.973. The low for the last 3 months is 2.7, the highest 3.11. The way that they plan on financing it, they're going to do bills, notes, and bonds. What the Treasury is actually expecting is going to be pretty intense, because they, when you take a look at the tax cut as well as the spending increase, the Congress approved the $300 billion spending increase. The tax cut is going to basically hit into the amount of money that we have coming into the Treasury. So I suspect they're going to be scrambling here as to how they're going to do this. What has to get kicked on ASAP, and we'll see if that's the case. So picture what we have. Yeah, the GDP came out, good GDP number. If it stays at those numbers, great. Bottom line is that the argument was made when they did the tax cut is that, hey, listen, if the gross domestic product rises tremendously, everyone's going to end up making money. Well, we'll find out if that's the case, or we'll find out that the government is not only in hock What would be really wild is that, you know, we don't have a crash, and the amount of debt that the government needs goes exponential because of the fact that they're not collecting on the other side. You got to remember something. You got one side of your balance sheet, you get the other side of the balance sheet. In our case, the balance sheet with the expenses is phenomenal versus a balance sheet that has the equity involved in it because of the fact that we've borrowed so much money for so long. You know, that being said, what you also have is this. You have huge amounts of dollars across the world, and that's not going to change, folks. That's just the way it is. If I go back, I don't care whether I go back 20, 30, 40 years, you know, you can throw the dollar anywhere, and guess what? People want the dollar. The dollar, in the aspect of it's transferable very quickly. You don't go to countries and they say, I'm not going to accept the dollar. In most countries right now, what you still have is that the dollar is stronger than their currency, and you probably won't get the rate that you should be getting when you transfer it. But bottom line is that it's never a problem transferring it. We go take a look at some of the other higher volume equities out there. Comcast or CBS. CBS, this is so Les Moonves, he's got some bottom line trouble in paradise out there. Him and Sherry Ridgestone have been fighting over this company for a huge amount of time. Bottom line is that, what do they say? So Moonves is going to stay at CBS as they probe allegations. What they are going to do is that they're going to postpone the board of directors meeting. But the equity has just gone from $59 to $51. So that equity has some problems.
Larry Pesavento has just started his brand new service, Fibonacci 24/7, and he's already delivering content to his subscribers on a daily basis when the market's opened and even on weekends. Each Monday, you'll receive Larry's written report that provides detailed commentary and a summary on the charts and videos that Larry sends out. And throughout the week, when warranted, Larry will send out via charts or videos or both the key markets that he is watching during the day. This will be up-to-the-date, active trading information that will help you in your daily trading. In Larry's first week alone, he sent out 25 charts, 6 videos, and a full report to his subscribers in just 1 week. If you're a technical trader that uses patterns and retracements to trade, then Larry's service Fibonacci 24/7 is something that you must try. Right now, new subscribers can get a full 30-day money-back guarantee. With nothing to risk, sign up now to Larry Pesavento's Fibonacci 24/7 by visiting the front page of TFNN.com. Under trading newsletters. David White's newsletter, The Technology Insider, is focused like a laser on finding the next big things in technology. If you had invested only $10,000 in Microsoft in 1986, you'd have been a millionaire by 2000. Disruptive technology like Microsoft's is the key to these massive long-term profits, and The Tech Insider is the vehicle from TFNN to capitalize on these opportunities. This is the go-to newsletter that identifies, monitors, and profits on mostly little-known cutting-edge companies with great long-term prospects. David's experience is as an inventor of Emmy-winning animation products for TV and Hollywood that propelled a company public. Match that with 14 years as a full-time trader, and he's uniquely qualified to guide you through the light-speed world of ever-evolving high-tech. If you're ready to ride the next big technology bull market for less than $40 per month, log on to TFNN.com and get your 2-week free trial to the Technology Insider. Get in on the ground floor of the next big thing today. With over $56 million in cash and over $66 million in working capital, Great Panther Silver is positioned as a company with a solid foundation and poised for growth. While completely unhedged to the price of silver, Great Panther retains 100% ownership in 2 producing mines in Mexico, which is the top silver producing country in the world, along with future potential production in Peru. Great Panther is highly leveraged to the price of silver, and after a great year of performance in 2016, Great Panther Silver has a strong outlook for 2017 as well. With good liquidity in trading and strong fundamentals on the balance sheet, while remaining completely unhedged to the price
price of gold and silver, now is a perfect time to take a closer look at this equity. If you'd like to find out more about Great Panther Silver, then go to greatpanther.com or check them out on the NYSE Market, symbol GPL, or the TSX, symbol GPR.
Don't forget, you can listen to TFNN live on your mobile device 24 hours per day. Go to TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV. That's TFNN.com, then hit Watch Tiger TV for the latest market information.
Welcome back, folks. You know, we were just talking about the amount of bonds they're going to send out, the deficit. This gets even, this is it. Listen to this. This, you'll be reading this tomorrow. So the same Mnuchin bottom line right now is at a G20 meeting in Argentina. And he just came out, and the administration is thinking of granting an additional $100 billion tax cut. Now, this tax cut here would basically go with to anyone that has a larger capital gains. And what this is about is that, this is pretty amazing that they're going to basically try this, I guess, is that they're going to bypass Congress. They're going to try to bypass Congress, and what they want to do is this. Mnuchin, it has to do with the aspect of capital gains and how they are subtracted from the original price. So picture that 20 years ago you bought a stock for $100,000. You sold it for $1 million, okay? Bottom line, you have capital gains of $900,000. What Mnuchin's talking about here is that they think that it should be adjusted for inflation. So if I took the same $100,000 stock, sold it for $1 million, and I went back to 1980, that $100,000 would actually be worth $300,000 now. So what the Treasury Secretary is saying is that they're looking to see whether they can get around Congress and make a regulation that you would only pay the capital gains cost between the $300,000 and the $1 million, which would be $700,000, and that investor would save $40,000 just on that deal alone. Bottom line, though, you can see where that is. I mean, that's not going to be all your workers out there getting a tax cut. That's going to be someone. I don't even think that's the ultra rich, because in order to basically have certificates for 30, 40 years, you're talking trusts. You're talking a whole different ball game. Whole different ball game. Always remember, folks, whatever you think about, you bring about. Whatever you focus on grows. And whatever you want in life, folks, visualize it like a nice big motion picture. Step into it, take ownership, and fly with it. Thanks for being here, folks. Have a great night, safe night. Look forward to speaking right back in our new headquarters, St. Petersburg, Florida, tomorrow morning, 8 o'clock. Well, go get them, folks.
TFNN is excited about our new software charting program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts. In collaboration with Tom O'Brien and using his best-selling book, The Art of Timing the Trade, Your Ultimate Trading Mastery System, David White has programmed an outstanding piece of software that will complement any trader's methodology. Using this first-of-its-kind program, The Art of Timing the Trade Charts allows you to scan thousands of stocks for Fibonacci formation setups, including Gartley's, ABC's, Butterflies, and much more. The Art of Timing the Trade Charts is designed to help you when scouring the markets for stocks just beginning to form the trading patterns that many investors spend days, weeks, or even months searching to find. And right now, we're offering licenses available at only $79 a month. We are so confident that you're going to love this new charting software that will even give you a 30-day unconditional money-back guarantee. Don't miss out on this incredible new piece of software. Get your copy of The Art of Timing the Trade Charts today by visiting TFNN.com.